Hello everyone, welcome, my name is Alpha Wolfie, and I'm on the PS4 playing Slay the Spire. What you can do is you can go to my Twitch channel, click on that follow button or that heart-shaped symbol, whichever system you're on. Hopefully you'll get the email to you when I'm broadcasting streaming-wise. Need to find information? Go to my Twitch channel, you'll find info section there. As always, do come into chat, chat about your favourite games, your favourite films, your favourite hobbies, how's your day been, hopefully good, or on the flip side, bad games, bad films, bad day, either way, chat with me and others. Come into chat, say hello if anything, don't be shy, I don't always see you listening, so do apologise for that happens, but do come to chat and chat about your stuff, and if you're on YouTube, leave your rates, comments and subscriptions and all that jazz. As always, keep the respect going. Lastly but not least, do us a donate button on my Twitch channel. If you go to my Twitch channel, click on that donate button, donate however much you can, when and wherever. All donations are greatly appreciated and help the wolf pack grow stronger. When you donate, thank you from the bottom of my heart, from me to you lot for donating, and hopefully I can give you lot some better chance for doing so. So without further ado, let's kick into this game. So first off, see what we get in settings. So we have game settings, input settings and credits. In game settings, you have graphics, shake screen, you can have it on or off. Your preferences, display summed up damage in gold, disable block damage in blue, disable confirmation when choosing one card, disable particle effects, and fast mode. You also have your master volume, your music volume, and effects volume, and ambient sound effects. So hopefully it's not too loud, it's not too soft. I might put it up a little bit tired. Let's do that if I can. Not sure how it's allowing me. Interesting. It doesn't. It's not going up or down. That's interesting. I'm clicking the buttons and pushing left and right. Using the R2, L2s, they don't seem to work. That just puts me back. Error. That's interesting. I can't touch these effects of sounds. No. Okay, never mind. Hopefully the sound's not too low. But anyway, with the R. The input settings, you got all those down there. And I'm sure the game will run me through all that stuff anyway. So that's what you basically have. Input settings, which was basically the other side. Don't know why they did that, but there we go. And then your typical credits, as always.
The sounds are fine, it has a good volume and this game is fantastic.
Ah! Oh, that's good to know. Thank you very much, Helios. Hey, I thought you were playing this game as well. Or have you had enough? Anyway, just a quick little run through. This game is on the Microsoft Store, I believe. Mainly Steam. It's also now on the PS4 and it was soon to be on the Nintendo Switch, I think June 6th, 7th, something like that. What is interesting is that the fact that this is on Steam, Microsoft Store, I think, something like
I
that.
I was fine for the day, was doing the daily challenge.
Oh, the daily challenge. Okay, something new in this game, I guess. So yeah, it's on Microsoft Store and Steam, but it's not on the Xbox One. No nasty comments. But it's just strange that, you know, it's on Steam, Microsoft Store, PS4, and now soon to be Nintendo Switch, but nothing on or news to be on the Xbox One, which is the oddest part of more. If it's on Microsoft and Steam, whatever, surely it should be mentioning that it will be eventually coming, but no such words is being put out there.
I did think that was strange.
Yeah. it's the weirdest thing, you know. It's on one platform but not the other. Not going to push it or rock the boat too much, but that sounds like typical Microsoft wanting you to go to PC side and what have you, but whatever. Anyway, into play. So you have your standard embark on a quest to slay the spear, daily climb, and custom. So I'm completely new to this genre. I'm not a card fan of any sorts, but the game did seem interesting, and a certain buddy is playing this game, Helios. There is. It looked simple enough. I mean, simple enough is like more like luck. But that's typical card gaming, isn't it? So let's kick into this. So
obsessed with it I am.
Yes. No doubt. But I'm a newbie at this, so this might be painful. So the Ironclad. The remaining soldier of the Ironclads sold his soul to harness the demonic energies. Burning is energy spelled like that? No, I don't know. Burning blood at the end of combat heals 6 HP. 5 unlocks remaining, 0 or 300 to next unlock. That's like what? But anyway, so I just embark, I guess. But yeah, I'm too new to this, and if it gets too complicated, oh dear. Oh, those screen texts at the top are small. I don't know if my PS4 has changed its screen size or anything, but anyhow, it looks like Square does something. I don't know what. I'm being timed already. That's not cool. L1 does something, and options as well. So I just go for it, I guess. Legendary.
It's pretty easy once you get the hangs of it, and my screen was like that too.
Ah, that's strange. Okay, if I'm maybe going into options. No, they don't have that, but I can tell you off, as one of my chat people, Helios, says that the screen size does not seem right. Because as you, on my screen, my name's called Lafarufi. It's missed out the A. So obviously, it's a little bit too big. That's strange, never mind. So I've got to go with that. Okay, so defeat enemies by playing cards from your hand. Cards require energy to play. Once you are out, end your turn. At the start of your turn, new cards are drawn and your energy is replenished. Tutorial 1 of 3. Play defensive cards to gain block when enemies are about to attack you. Block reduces incoming attack damage, but wears off at the start of your next turn. During your turn, you can observe an enemy's intent above them. Aha. Uh-huh. If an enemy is intent on attacking you, be sure to gain some block. Oh god, here we go. I'm ready. Player's turn. See, this is what's so annoying. When I watched your stream, Helios, you were like, shuffle, 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 done, 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 done. So deal 6 damage, deal 6 damage, gain 5 block, deal 8 damage, apply to 2 vulnerable, I've saved that, gain 5 block. So I'm gonna go with deal 6. Okay. That one. Uh-huh. And they're gonna attack. I think I can manage without the block. They're not gonna be doing something bad to me.
Lol, my bad. Once you re into it, ULL fly through the cards. Info, follow me on Twitter. URL, YouTube. URL, schedules. Donate button. Setups.
Sorry about the voice text and my info section. But yeah. Microphone, sorry. So, next time. Deal 6. How much have they got on them? Oh, they can be dead in seconds. I'm gonna end turn. So, they knocked off 10. Tip, no more cards. If there are no more cards to draw, you discard pile is shuffled into the draw pile. Okay. He's a goner. So I've got rewards, and that's 19 gold, swift potion, and add a card to your deck. Rare cards have a golden frame and banner. Okay. Tip, potions. Drink or throw potions during combat. Potions stay with you between rooms. Choose a card. See, I'm not skilled in knowing what would be best, but gain 10 block, deal 5 damage if an enemy has vulnerable, gain and coins, and deal 8 damage to all enemies. What would you choose? Ghost, drop, or cleave? The drop does the attack, and the cleave does the attack, but the skill is something else. I mean, gain 10 blocks, quite good. Ish. 8 damage to all of them.
And cleave.
Cleave. Okay. Proceed. Okay, so this is going to be slow, but I did warn you.
But lot. The 1-0 block is useful.
Ah, thanks. So, we have that, which is merchant. I don't think I really have enough of a merchant. But looking up, there's not many merchants left. That sucks. Wow game. I'm gonna go with that one. As you walk into the room, you hear a gurgling and a grinding of metals. Before you is a slime-like creature that ate too much scrap for its own good. From the center of the creature...
But hey, this is your run, Alpha. I'm just an observer.
It doesn't matter. I'm good with whatever little people say. creature you see glinted of a strange light, perhaps something magical. It looks like you can get some treasure if you just reach inside its opening. However, the acid and sharp objects may hurt. Reach inside, lose 3 HP, 25%, find a relic. Reach inside. Son of a bitch. Ouch, all you find is a corroded metal and a bit of burning pain. However, you're still convinced that there's a... God! All you find is a corroded metal, but a bit of burning pain. Blah, blah, blah. This sucks. This sucks. This sucks. Leave. That sucks. Like how? Ah. Oh. Ooh, unknown. Let's go for that. Oh, I can't believe I did that. I got greedy. Among the stone and boulders, you notice the large blue statue resembling Elf's wing. You find gold spilling from its cracks. Maybe there's more inside. You kidding? I thought this was a card game, not yes, no, maybe so. Thank God for that. Someone once told you a cult that was worshipped. But as you kneel in prayer, you begin to feel lightheaded. You wake up sometime later, feeling strangely fleet of foot. Ooh. Select a card to remove. Son of a gun.
No bad mouthing, Slay the Spire, I see high.
Battle. Ooh, okay. We're both gonna deal six. Deal six to that one, deal six to that one. And I'll take five block. Not enough energy. Bullsh. I'm going to die, aren't I? Can I block now? Yes, please. I'll go for that one. Ooh, energy. I've got to get used to that. Energy cost. Cards require energy to play. These orbs at the bottom left indicate how much you can. Okay. Got that. Damn, here we go. Ow. Fine. Oh, jeez. There we go. This card applies a power to you when used. Powers are passive abilities that remain for the duration of combat. At the end of your turn, deal one damage to all enemies for each attack played this turn. That's rubbish, but never mind. I'm gonna go with that one. So I've got to keep going. So this game at the moment, I believe in UK price, pounds, is £19.99, which is not a bad price. So I really can do. So I hope I'm playing this correctly. Draw 3 cards. Nah. Oh, Jesus. I'm too low on health. So, I have apply 1 week to all enemies, exhaust. Draw 1 card, put a card from your hand on top of your draw pile.
Okay. Use all your attack points if you can. If the enemy has the red sword above its head, block. If it has the blue flame attack, then easy.
In theory. Not when you have 12% health. I'm going to go with that one. Crap. And it has legs, great. Dead, don't I? Ugh. I told you this was going to be painful. New counter. Wow, harsh. Let's compliment, view all the cards you have encountered throughout the sphere, examine various trinkets and artifacts obtained through your runs. Don't think I have to. So you got, now you've got daily climb, a new challenge is available once a day. Compete with other players for the highest score. And custom is yet to be unlocked. I'm no good at this, but why not? Okay. So trophies are off the daily climb. So no, I'm not gonna do that. And then we got this one, the silent. So at the start of each combat, draw 2 additional cards. That's way better. Greetings. I am new. Neil. I don't know. I brought you back. So enemies in your next three combats have 1 HP. What? Why would I want that one? Granted. That's interesting.
I took the 1 HP. Topic, what's your favorite game, film, hobbies, how's your day? Or worst game, film, bot day? Chat away with me and others, please come in.
Okay, so... 6 damage. Gain 5 block. Deal 3 damage, apply to 1 weakened. And turn. My power is unmatched. What's this? Gain 8 block, but discard 1 card. Okay, so deal damage. End turn. Yeah, I would agree to people saying that, you know, the game may be tough, but the playing style of it isn't that tough. Because, I mean, I'm already getting the hang of it. It's like deal 6 damage. It's kind of a typical card game where it's luck of the draw, which you could say your fate is already written slightly. Dead. My power's one matched. Okay, so we have dash. Gain 10 block, 10 damage. Draw 3 cards, discard 1. Next gain. That's a new one.
I like the game, as you can't build a deck at the start, you build it as you go along, so do you go for lots of cards for choice, or lesses?
You're probably right. Okay, so let's go for damage that one. That one. And block. Yeah, I'm getting the hang of this now. Hmm. Still painful. I was licked. Oops, keep forgetting, I only have three. That's a no-brainer. See why I'm now starting to flick through the cards pretty quickly now. Not too complicated. And the last kill. So gain 10 block. All enemies lose 6 strength. This turns exhaust. Deal 3 damage 5 times.
Remember, alpha cards with 0 cost nothing to use.
That too. I don't like the question marks. Oh, he's defending. Oh, shit. He's got 5 left. Oh, not enough. Damn. Oops, I got greedy. Ouch. Dead. Okay. Deals 5 damage. Deal 9 damage. Draw 1 card. Gain 4 block. Next turn, gain 4 block.
Haha, look at the card numbers, Alpha. UV got this.
No, I wouldn't go that far. Son of a bitch. Denied. Broke a bit. I've got to block a bit. Oh, greedy again. God, I keep forgetting the controls. Anyway. So, games I've been playing recently. Kind of recently, I would say Rage 2. I'm still playing that, so I'm getting the hang of it. It's a fun game. But it's fairly average. But I haven't been playing too much of gaming, which is kind of annoying. I've been mostly watching
I
films.
Need to get back to Rage 2, just to complete it then delete it.
Blimey. You do know Rage 2 is an open world. Good luck with that. Yay! I live another day. 15 gold, skill points, and add a card to your deck. This game gets a little bit tough as you get into the middle part. You start to scream for more. So choose one of three random skill cards to add to your hand and cost zero turns. Why not?
Blade Dance is a useful card.
Ah. Oh. Fine. I'm not gonna survive this. Thank you. No, you can't do that. Ah, shoot. As far as I can do it, I'm dead. Ow. Easy to understand, difficult to master. New character. See, you make this game look so easy when I watch people to play this. I'm doing crap. I also played Daily Climb to unlock this game mode. So, the defect. The combat automaton, which became self-aware. Ancient technology allows the manipulation of orbs. Cracked core. At the start of each combat, channel one lightning. So I'm just going to go of those characters. Greetings. Talk. I brought you back. How nice. Let's do that.
ULL, get the hang of it, Alpha. Just look at the card numbers, what they are worth at GEC, so you know what to play. Donate however much you can. All donations are greatly appreciated and help so much. Thank you. URL.
Deal 3 damage, apply 1 vulnerable. Deal 6 damage, channel 1 frost. At the start of your turn, add a random common card onto your hand. That's rubbish. I'm gonna go with that one. Let's go for mystery.
I think ULL like the defect, it has my fav character.
I see. Okay. As you come to a dead end and begin to turn around, walls slam down from the ceiling, trapped you. Three faces materialize from the walls and speak. Forget what you know, and I'll let you go. I require change to see a new space. If you want to pass me, then you must grow. Upgrade. Okay, now that's done. Next one. You come across an inconspicuous pedestal with a shining gold idol sitting peacefully atop. It looks incredibly vulnerable. So you're sure don't see any traps nearby. Yeah, right. I'll rather take that, son of a bitch. It's obvious that it's going to do those things, isn't it, really? Ooh. Banana. I'm gonna go with that one. easy enough. So at the start of your turn, trigger the passive ability of your next orb. What's that loop? At the start of your turn, trigger the passive ability. Why would you want to be passive? Deal 3 damage, increase the damage of all claw cards by 2 this combat. Deal 3 damage, apply 1 vulnerable. Beam. I'm gonna go with that one. Upgrade a card in your deck. Well, I'm not that down on stuff, so I might as well smith it.
The defect has orbs. Lightning is good for attacks after playing cards. Frost would give you 2+ shield. It doesn't explain it at all.
Yeah. That's hardly any good either. But I'll take it. I like that. I like that a lot. Speaking of which, Helios, I think you're the only one in the chat room. Have you bought any 4K films yet?
Not yet.
Not yet. What would make you go for a 4K film? That's interesting. Ooh, treasure.
Haha, would have to be a heavy special effect film, I guess. Blade Runner 2049 would be a good start.
The problem with 4K films, I think I've mentioned it before, is that some 4K films are not true 4K, which just makes me angry because I think I mentioned it in a tweet somewhere along the lines, is that they display saying on casing 4K Ultra HD blah 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 blah, but some of the films are not a true 4K, they're upscaled. So how can they say it's a 4K film when it's upscaled to 4K? Which makes it not a true 4K, which is a little bit naughty. But yes, Blade Runner 2049, I think you said. I've got that in my 4K collection. It's not bad. What's this? Oh, right, coinage. I get it. Oh, I'm just short of that one. That's not fair. Add one random colorless card onto your hand, exhaust. That one's not bad.
I am going to play some FIFA now. Enjoy the rest of the game. RTU out as well. Ladders.
So you're going to play some FIFA 19. Okay, cool. That's on your Xbox One, I presume. Yeah. 4K. Xbox One X, should I put it that way? Cool. Thank you for coming in. And as always, a pleasure. Take care. And I will be finishing pretty shortly, because I've pretty much gone through all the three characters. It's an interesting game, it's simple enough, harder to play. I don't get that much. It's already done. Go up there. I got. See, the path to the right seems better because there's two rest points. I'll go with that one. Why not? I want to reach the top. No doubt this one's going to be harder. Oh yeah, I have to end my turn now. Ow. I can live with that. Cancel that one, enter. Easy, dead. Deal 10 damage per all 0 costs. I like that one. Smith it. Where was that one? There. Well, it's something. We get to rest again. Let's fully rest. Heal up. Proceed. Well, here we are, folks. I made it. Holy Mother Teresa. 240. Oh, not enough. Okay, yep, end my turn. I don't like that. 32, son of a gun. Ow. Holy mother! Oh, right, yeah. Thank you. Yep. Okay. I don't want to do that. Okay. Am I gonna win this? Oh, that was the two, so... Oh. I'm getting there, folks. I'm getting there. Yes! Did it. At the start of your turn, draw one card additional. Deal 7 damage to random enemies, each lightning channel of this combat, blah blah blah. Prevent next time you would lose HP. Hmm. We're gonna go with Thunderstrike. So we get the treasure chest. Why would you want to skip it? Choose a relic. Gain. At the start of your turn, you cannot play more than 6 cards per turn. Gain. At the start of your turn, future cards rewards will have 2 less cards to choose. Okay. At the start of your turn, you can no longer gain gold. What? Oh God. I guess. So Act 2, the city. So you got to keep going. Oops. That was my fault there. Sorry about that. Excuse me. So, so save and quit is R2. So you continue abandoned one. Good lord. Interesting. So two deaths, 28, one boss slain. That's quite a lot. I see. Oops. So we've done pretty much all of that, haven't we? So, back to this. So this has been Slay the Spire. Microsoft Store, Steam, PS4. And soon to be a Nintendo Switch, but not for Xbox One, which is weird, but still, you know, live in hope. But that's for the other people. I think that's kind of mean that, you know, some game like this, they could have gone on all platforms just like that, you know. But yeah, there we go. Thank you for Helios Erez and anyone else that's been watching. Much appreciated. So yeah, Slay the Spire, being played on the PS4. Do go to my Twitch channel, click on that follow button or that heart shape symbol, whichever system you're on, and hopefully you get the email since you went and broadcasting stream wise. Need to find information, that's on my Twitch channel. As always, do come to chat about your favourite games, favourite films, favourite hobbies, how's your day been, hopefully good. On the flip side, bad games, bad films, bad day. Either way, chat with me and others, come to chat, say hello and everything, don't be shy. I don't always see the listed names, so I do apologize about that, but do come to chat, and if you're on YouTube, leave your rates, comments and subscriptions and all that jazz. As always, keep the respect going. Last but not least, there is a donate button on my Twitch channel. Go to that, donate however much you can, when and wherever. All donations are greatly appreciated and help the Wolfpack grow stronger. When you donate, thank you from the bottom of my heart for meeting a lot for donating. And hopefully I can give you lots of better shots of doing so. So it's an interesting game. Worth a pickup. Even a dummy like me can play it. So thanks for joining up, peeps. Much respect to you all. See you next time. Until then, take care. And...